It's the Vive Pro, HTC's Pro version of their Vive VR headset. The Vive Pro comes loaded with some upgraded optics and the potential for wireless VR. Potential because we're still waiting on that wireless adapter. But even after all these upgrades, the Pro is surprisingly easy to take apart. The headphones are both easily removable and potentially replaceable, and the head strap comes off after taking out just a few screws. There were some hidden screws securing the headset cover, and once we released a few clips, it slid right off. The cover is covered in tiny little IR windows that allow the sensors to see the IR light from the Lighthouse space stations. Speaking of sensors, check out that sensor array. It's very similar in appearance to the array used in the original Vive. Unlike other VR systems that use IR projectors in the face mask for tracking, the Vive's array consists of receivers that are gathering data from the IR projecting lighthouses. After disconnecting some cables and removing a few more screws, we were able to lift away the sensor array. On the back of the array, you'll find the first of the two PCBs we found inside the Vive Pro. This one is responsible for all the sensors and cameras and is home to the 2.4 GHz Nordic Semiconductor ultra-low power system on chip. Digging further underneath that board, we find a thick slab of copper shielding covering the cameras. The second board is attached to the top of the display assembly and is responsible for the audio and video hardware. On this board, you can find the ST Microelectronics ARM Cortex M0 microcontroller, which is the same one that was used in the last Vive. Both of the boards we found inside the Vive are loaded with chips, and if you're wanting to see the full list, head over to the teardown over on our site. Last out are the displays. The Vive Pro uses two 1440p AMOLED displays for a combined resolution of 2880 by 1600 and a pixel density of 615 pixels per inch. This adds up to a 37% increase in pixel density and a 78% increase in pixels from the original Vive. With the Vive Pro fully disassembled, it's time to think about repairability. The Vive Pro scored an 8 out of 10. And here's why. On the upside, disassembly with standard tools is straightforward, non-destructive, and free of booby traps. Newly added earphones are completely modular and come with instructions for removal and installation. Standard Phillips and Torx screws secure most of the components, and the high-wear comfort pads are secured with Velcro. Compatibility with existing controllers and base stations means you already know how to repair the required accessories. Adhesive secures the lenses, microphone, and sensor arrays. But on the downside, this is an unusually complex device with a lot of delicate bits. You'll want to be armed with a service manual before diving into any repair.